How goes the family? Welcome back to Patterson Properties. Hopefully you guys are having a great and exceptional Sunday. Going to be covering the options that a lot of renters may have out here. I've covered, you know, obviously in certain instances throughout the whole year and a half since the pandemic started, how various other packages from forbearance to rental assistance and all this other good stuff. But there's actually an opportunity for people to get a stimulus of $25,000. As a friend of mine would like to call, straight up cash in hand. Before I go forward, remember Patterson Properties purchases are delinquent tax properties and sell wholesales them to various amounts of investors. So, and we obviously help homeowners in certain situations get rid of their home if they need to. So if you need to contact Patterson Properties, all our information is in the description, whether you're on Facebook, whether you're on YouTube, Instagram, et cetera. Anyways, in these struggling times when it boils down to everything, lots and lots of people are struggling to pay their rent and mortgages, even though there have been a lot of rental assistance and mortgage forbearance programs to assist people with any issues that one may have at this time. According to the article that I read today, more than a year later, the United States of America's housing is in volcanic stages, in a sense, thanks largely to the ultra low mortgage rates. Heck, I mean, you know, I would imagine a lot of others have definitely taken advantage and benefited from the low interest rates that we've seen for the last year and a half. But while homeowners have seen the value of their houses surge, people who rent have not been so fortunate because so many of them work in industries clobbered by the pandemic, like hospitality and retail. Many renters haven't been able to earn a steady income in over a year. Millions upon millions are behind on their rent, unfortunately, and it isn't stopping anytime soon. The article also stated that the federal ban on evictions has just been extended another month to July 31st. And obviously that is passed because we're in August now. And others can find help available because there's billions still left in federal rent relief that's available under the last two COVID stimulus packages. You could receive as much as, and I say it's not a guarantee, but the article says as much as $25,000, depending on where you live. I would imagine people in California, New York, and DC qualify for this, because since in Hawaii too, whole West Coast, whole Northeast, because you know these are considered the most expensive areas in the country. Now, the idea of getting $25,000 is always a good idea in my book. You know, hey, and especially if it can not only put one in a position where they can pay their bills off, but even put their one in a position where they can save some money, invest their money, and, you know, even maybe in the future, possibly become a homeowner. You know, the article, you know, you got to take the good with the bad. That's my mindset. I try to find a positive in any negative situation. The article stated that to be eligible, at least one member of your household must qualify for unemployment benefits and must be willing to state in writing that the pandemic has been responsible for a lost income or surging expenses that have made it difficult to pay rent. One will also have to prove through either a past due utility or rent notice that you are at risk of homelessness. Plus, there's an economic component. Your 2020 income must have fallen below 80% of your community's median income. One can find and apply to the appropriate local housing body through the website of the National Low Income Housing Coalition. Renters who qualify can get up to 18 months of assistance that will cover both missed and future rent. So if you are in this category, please look into this, family. Also, the article also stated that if you've had to lean on your credit cards or other high interest debt to cover your purchases during the pandemic, the interest charges will be stalking you and your budget for months. You might be able to roll those balances into a lowered interest debt consolidation loan that you could actually pay off, that will actually pay off your debt more quickly and affordably. So getting one's debts down is always in your best interest, no matter if it's good debt or bad debt. But do not forget to consult a financial professional. Don't just listen to some random dude on YouTube and Facebook and whatnot. But, you know, I love to just put this information out there, because at any time, you just never know when somebody could use it. This kind of assistance, especially in today's world, right? So do the great three free things. Like, share, and subscribe. Have a great day. And as I always say, make money moves, or you're going to live broke like a fool. Take care.